Black Friday time, y'all. Hey friends, welcome back. My name is Maggie, and the only thing I love more than makeup is dismantling sales one by one. Today we're going to take a look at Sephora's Black Friday preview. I'm actually kind of glad that a lot of brands are doing this now because I think it's easier to talk yourself out of potential purchases if you know what they're going to try and lure you in with in advance. So let's do that together, shall we? I had to download the Sephora app just to look these up, and right away I'm like, I see you, Sephora. I see you trying to lure me in. Is it a little too bright, or... Viewfinder seems to have no problems. Sorry for blinding y'all in the intro. Whoops. Anyways, let's scroll through and see what Sephora is gonna try and make us spend money on. Okay, so the first thing that I am seeing is the Urban Decay Naked palettes, the colorful ones. Naked Honey, Naked Cherry, and Naked Heat are half off, kind of. This is a little weird. Naked Honey and Naked Cherry are now $24.50, and they were originally priced at $49, but Naked Heat is now $27, and it was originally $49, so... That's a little inconsistent, but I guess I get it. My thing is, if you didn't buy these eyeshadows in the months following their debut, you're not interested in them. You're not gonna buy them now if you didn't want to buy them before. So take off your sales goggles. If that didn't make you want to buy the product, then you were never gonna buy it in the first place. So no. I'm seeing a lot of Anastasia Glow Kits on here for half off. And again, the thing I said previously, if you weren't going to buy it then, you're not going to buy it now. I also feel like the Glow Kits, or just having a palette that's strictly for highlighters, is just not a thing that people do anymore, so they may just be trying to clear out stock, and that's something to keep in mind as you're scrolling through these deals and just think, is this a legitimately good deal, or are they just trying to clear out stock? And I suspect, I can't confirm, but I suspect that's what the case is here, just because I think glow kits were something that we really loved when they first came out, and now we just want the Amreezy highlighter back. I'm also noticing there are a lot of mini kits on here, and they're priced very temptingly. There's a Clinique kit that was $15, now $10, and it says it's originally $25 value. There's a Tarte Fresh Faced and Festive set, originally $23, now $15. It's supposedly a $41 value. Just look at these kits. Pause and think, how many times have I used a mini product on purpose? I have a couple of minis that I really love and enjoy using, but for the most part, the amount of kits that I've gotten with mini products, I just never reach for them. I never can find a way to make them work in my collection, and that's something that I've come to realize about myself as a consumer, is I'm just somebody who likes the full-size product, and there's nothing wrong with that. I think that's just what I'm used to. And if you're like me, or if you just have a pattern of not using the mini products that come in these kits, then I would suggest maybe skipping over them this time around. Okay, I think we've roasted Sephora all we can. Do you guys want to see what the Ulta Black Friday deals are? Because I kind of do. If I have to download an app, I'm gonna be so disappointed. Okay, if you guys are curious, Ulta doesn't make you download an app just to see what their Black Friday deals are. It looks like it's going to go all week long while supplies last, starting online Saturday, so I guess you don't have to worry about getting online at a certain time on Friday, which is kind of nice. I appreciate that. Okay, so the Ulta Beauty Collection is now 50% off. It is a giant... It looks like... Do y'all remember those art palettes from like 1,000 years ago? I know I had one as a kid and it looked amazing, but the quality was garbage. That's what I'm getting reminded of here. And this kind of breaks my heart because Ulta, the house brand, is such great quality, but anytime they do these holiday collections and these massive packagings, it's just, it's never the Ulta brand quality that I'm used to. So for those reasons, I'm out. I've also noticed a lot of the beauty finds, all of the beauty finds are 50% off. And this is, I think, going to tempt people the most. The scent sampler kits especially, just because the box looks so enticing. So to argue that point, I will sort of say like $15 for that with the gift card. It's consumer psychology, essentially. They're trying to make you think like, oh, well, it basically cancels each other out. So the gift card is going to be used on any of the fragrances in that box specifically. It's not a general Ulta gift card, although how great would that be? So it goes on a couple of assumptions. Number one, you will like all of the perfumes that you get in that sampler kit, and I think fragrance is so personal, and it has so many variants. And people can be incredibly picky, myself included, about what fragrances they do and do not like. And not to mention allergies. Let's remember that certain people have sensitivities or allergies to certain scents in the first place. And you just may not like any of the scents included in this kit. So it's really kind of $15 in the garbage already. Also, kind of going off of the whole intended additional purchase with that, their whole idea with these kits is that they're taking a loss on this product, right? So they're hoping that you end up liking one or more of the scents so much that you walk right back into the store and spend however much it is on fragrance. And these are all luxury premium fragrances, so they are quite expensive. They're hoping that they can lure you in with that initial kit so that they can make money back when you end up buying that fragrance. So this product, I believe it's called a loss leader. I'm not super familiar. But so these loss leading products, like, they know they're gonna take a hit, but they're hoping, and what ends up usually happening is you come back into the store to buy the full size product, and that's where they make their money. So knowing that, it feels a little gross, doesn't it? And just kind of think, like, these are a lot of tiny little bottles. Are you the kind of person who likes using those for fragrances in the first place? I certainly don't. Not usually. So it's essentially like one step towards purchasing a fragrance. And if that's something you're not able to do at the moment due to monetary issues, then I would suggest you stay away from that product and just their beauty kits in general. Cause I found that with loss leading products, it can be difficult to stay away. That's why they throw in the gift card. They're hoping to kind of bring you back into the store. Some more of these vault-type collections. There are the usual, like, NYX holiday collections where they have every lip product they've ever made. Those are gonna be up to 50% off. And then ColourPop has the Ultra Matte Lip Vault. Whoa. This is one of those things where I would say, I feel like by now we're a lot better at avoiding these kinds of products, but just kind of think about how often today, actually, this is a great example. Today, how often are we wearing lipstick? You know, we do have to wear a mask, and nobody likes getting lipstick smeared all over their mask and their face, so a lot of us aren't even wearing lip products in the first place. Lipstick, especially the liquid kind, has a very limited shelf life. So do you really want to put that kind of economic pressure on yourself to use up these products before their expiration date? And if you like a lot of these shades, I would just suggest kind of buying them individually. Start out small. I talked about this in my Black Friday sales tactics video. You don't have to buy everything in bulk all at once. I know that can be really tempting and it's difficult to avoid, but just start out with one or two shades, see how you like the colors, see how you like the formula, how it wears, and then decide how you'd like to build out your collection from there. Oh, this leads me to a good point, and I'll try to end the video on here so I'm not too ranty. But I've noticed, and this isn't directed to one brand in particular because there are several brands who are doing this, is when they advertise something, let's say, for example, eyeshadow palettes, and they'll say eyeshadow palettes are 30% off, but only select palettes. So you may be so excited thinking like, oh, I finally can get this palette that I've really been after on a good deal, but it's not one of the ones that you were hoping was going to be on sale because it's only select palettes. That's like a foot in the door tactic that's pretty common in sales because they're hoping that you'll think, well, while I'm here, I better take a look at what else is available. And then you end up buying a palette that you weren't planning on getting in the first place. So just be aware of those kind of tactics. Again, I cover this a bit in my Black Friday sales tactics video. Go watch that if you haven't already. In looking at these Black Friday deals, I really don't see anything that is prompting me to buy anything. And a lot of things that are drawing my attention in the first place, once I kind of pick them apart, I don't think I'll buy them after all. So I hope you all found this video helpful and maybe it kind of scratched that consumer itch for you. Let me know if you're actually planning on getting anything for Black Friday. Let me know what your plans are. Let me know if you like this video, what kind of videos you'd like to see in the future. And I'll see you all in my next video. Bye.